What's up, YouTube? Felipe here, and in today's episode of Stargist, you're watching Let Me Tell You Something, and today we're going to be talking about kombucha.
It's the booch, nooch. Give me the booch.
Not beer. Not coffee. What do I mean? I lived in Portland for about a year. And it was amazing there because the craft beer scene and just people brewing and fermenting and making things over there is extremely awesome. But one thing I started to notice, and it was kind of different being a Californian, all the places that have beer on tap, all the places you can take home growlers and just really to get these drugs and take home some beer with you and put that right in your fridgey fridge, which was super cool. It's even better than taking home a six pack because it came right off the tap. You can't beat that, yeah. I've never been somewhere there were so many tap houses, so many breweries, just so many amazing beverages made with love. That's when I first started noticing the rise of kombucha.
Booch, huh?
Tell me more. What could I learn from you? Why do you exist? You didn't exist years ago. I mean, you've existed for centuries, to be real here. But why are you existing now, here, in America, on our grocery shelves? Didn't just come out of nowhere. It might seem like it did, but there's other things that influenced why this happened. I think when people are choosing kombucha as an option, what they're really saying is, I don't want a coffee, but it's still too early for a beer. It's not happy hour yet. I think they might end up getting a beer later on, or maybe after one or two kombuchas. But what I think they're saying, again, what's happening here, it's that it's serving this new in-between, right? It's serving this new need that's kind of been uncovered, right? Shoveled all the shit out of the way. If you think about what these beverages do is they really just bring people together. It's a conduit. All these beverages act as a tool for a natural exchange of ideas. And regardless whether it's a beer, kombucha, or a coffee, I think they're all really looking to solve that need for you. Health has a huge part to play with it. I mean, over the years, you're seeing a lot of health trends happen in many different categories. No matter if they relate to beverages or not, more people are meditating, there's more mindfulness and wellness things happening, yoga, people are vaporizing versus combustion. So there's this perfect storm, there's this world of all of these different health isms happening. People talk about kombucha as this replacement to soda. I think it can be, but again, if you've seen La Croix and all these other mineral waters or bubbly seltzers, there's a whole world of seltzers there that I think fill that need anyways. Not to say, well, if I don't want a seltzer, why can't I have a kombucha? You want something with bubbles, right? But I think if you're thinking health and you're thinking wellness, what I think someone's saying when they're saying, I would like a kombucha, please, is what they're saying is, I would have enjoyed a beer right now, but I will take something healthy that has some probiotic benefits to it. It has little stuff going in the body going boom, 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 do me some good. Right, that's what it does when it gets into your body. Why are people eating more kimchi? Why are people eating more sauerkraut? Right, probiotics, gut health, more yogurts, Yakult, it's alive. Good for my gut, good for my general health and well-being. And I think that's what a kombucha is really doing when people are buying it. And that's why I say it's not beer and not a coffee. The booch nooch. Interesting thing here, if I get out the old lappy top and bring up Nielsen.com, look. Nielsen calls it the bar experience without the buzz. And again, you've probably seen Sober October, Dry January. There's all these trends and things that are happening, right? And if you even Google like non-alcoholic bars or sober bars, it's a thing that's popping up. And what they serve is kombucha. Yes, now I know anyone in the comment section is gonna say, but Felipe, hey Stargist, there's actually alcohol in kombucha. That is non-alcoholic. Here's something else that's interesting, right? I'm sure you've heard the term, and I'm reading off my laptop here. Sober curious. It's a trend Nielsen reports is driven by millennials, citing that health, losing weight, and price are amongst the biggest reasons for this trend, of which has caused alcohol sales to go flat. The term mocktail. How long has that existed in the human language as like a term that we've been using? Say it with me, guys. When new trends happen, new products happen. Whatever you make, whatever product category you're in general, I just encourage you to look at patterns, find these trends, really wonder why new products exist when you do see them in the grocery store. I cannot go into the store without noticing something new if, to me, I didn't see it before, because I want to wonder why it exists, who's buying it, who's this for, what use case is it solving, and really understand the logic behind the launch. Why have these new products came to be? That's what I want to teach here. This is what Stardust is about. So that's what I find interesting. Deal with it. Hey, thanks for watching. Watch me again. Like, subscribe, share. And with that being said, guys, I'm out. We did it. We interneted, we YouTubed, and I'm out of here. So stay tuned. I'll be back with something next week in the Stardust lineup. Till then, I love you guys. Call your moms. Bye-bye, man.